going to center ourselves, set our intention for the practice today. Taking a couple of deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth, letting the muscles in your face soften. Feeling the contact of the floor beneath you. And let's just do a quick body scan, noting any imbalances, areas of discomfort or tension. Note that it's there. Keep moving through every muscle group. Don't skip a one. Your body, scanning all the way through the abdomen into the legs, and into the calf muscles, the feet, take a moment now to set your intention for the class, or maybe reflect on the motivation that brought you here. One more deep breath in and opening our eyes on the exhale, coming back to the presence of the room. Hands are going to be in front of our legs, and we're going to use the legs as leverage. On the inhale, we're rolling the shoulders back, arching. On the exhale, we're rounding out, dropping the head. Go to your breath. Sink as deeply as you can, warming up, sinking a little deeper with each breath. Shoulder blades back together. Two more. Reset, this time with the hands against the knees, pulling on those knees to squeeze the shoulders, blades back as you sink into the stretch. So on the inhale, pull back. Exhale, round out. Repeat to your breath. Four more. Last Inhale to reset. Putting our left hand on the ground, up on the fingertips, raising the right arm up. Exhale, slightly bend into that, walking the fingers out until you can get onto your forearms, with keeping the butt still on the ground. Slowly sink into it. Some muscles and ligaments relax. Keep the sit bones both on the mat. Slowly starting to make your way around on the exhales. Reaching for the corner, shooting past your knee, dropping your head, chin to chest. Slowly roll up, reset in the center. Fingertips of your right hand now are out on the mat. Inhale, bring the left arm up. Exhale, slowly side bend, sinking deeper with every exhale. Trying to walk those hands out till you're on your forearm, keeping the sit bones on the mat. Every exhale, slowly start to roll to the corner. One step at a time. Bringing the hands together when you get there. And folding over that knee, reaching out as far as you can. Chin to chest. Slowly walk yourself back up, stacking the vertebrae one at a time, nice and gentle. And we're going to open the legs nice and wide here. Position yourself with those hands, try and scooch yourself forward as much as possible. I'm going to grab for the left toe, bend, engaging that shoulder blade, looking up to the ceiling. Flexing the foot. Drawing yourself closer into the knee with every exhale. Center, and then we're reaching over to the other foot, grabbing for the toe, side bend, arm comes up over the head, engage the shoulder blades to draw it back, looking up to the ceiling. Two more breaths. And roll up gently, releasing that. Nice forward fold this time. Again, be gentle on your body. Do what you can. We're going to do a frog pose later on, which will help open up the abductors as well. But for now, reach forward as much as you can. Pulse, if that helps, break into it a little. Releasing all the tension that might be stored in your neck. Two more breaths. And slowly push yourselves up. Nice. We're going to bring those legs into the center and stack them on top of each other. Double pigeon. Would anybody like a block?
I don't even know where to put it. I have shit. I mean, it's not very flexible. But even after the block, I mean, nothing will help.
You're fine. Sure. Okay. Good stuff. Eagle arms, interlace, entwine the arms. And on the exhales, raise those arms. Inhale, bring the arms back down. And we're repeating this motion 10 times. So long as you're breathing, one inhale moves one way, exhale moves the other way. I'm not too concerned. And now rotate the opposite direction of the underneath arm. Nice and tall upper body. Good deep breaths. Help massage the spine. And release back to center. Bring those arms down. Stacking the legs the opposite direction. And we'll do the same with the arms. Two more. And rotate on your exhale. Again, away from the underneath arm. Nice and tall upper body. Feel those lungs. One more breath, and on the exhale, release, come back to center, bring those arms down. We're just going to forward fold, dropping your chin to your chest, arms are along the side, stacking a little extra weight on your legs, opening up the IT band. piriformis, everything that runs from the butt all the way through to the knees. Nice deep breaths. On your next exhale, roll up. Cross those legs one more time, the opposite side, and we'll forward fold to balance out the stretch in the leg. And if it helps you to pulse, then go right ahead. Next exhale, roll yourselves up. Hopefully you felt a little bit of release in the back of the legs, a little bit. We're coming into a boat, nice and gentle transition here. So we're going to start with just a boat hold, reaching the opposite arm past the opposite knee. We're just going to hold, so come in. However you can move into it, into a C-sit, and then straighten those legs and let the arms go. So, just do a nice gentle rotation against the knee. Switch to the other side. Bringing both arms to either side. We're going to do a Pilates pump. We're just going to pump the arms. Halfway. Shavasana, take a nice second here to relax the lower back. Nice deep breaths. From here, extending the arms over your head, we're just going to do a hollow hold. So arms are against the ears, heels of the feet are together. On the exhale, you're raising up about a foot off the ground with the arms and the legs. Inhale, come back down. We're repeating this 10 times. Bulletproof your back with your breath. Good. Keep those arms straight against the ears. Lifting about a foot. Two more. And rest. Release the arms. Feel the weight just pour into the ground. Catch your breath. We're going to transition to kneeling, but on the way through, we're going to do a side plank on the forearm. So elbow is right underneath the shoulder. You can scissor, stack, or knee assist, whichever works for you today. On the exhale, push on up. And just hold. Try to settle your breathing. bend that arm over your head, arching a little bit up the side. You got it. Four more breaths. And come on down. Switching to the other side. Nice and gentle transition. Elbows point under the shoulder, pressing up on the exhale. Pulling that arm over your head, arching the side. Get a side bend in there as well. Stacking the arm, gives a little extra weight to it. Two more breaths. And lower down. Nice and gentle, come up on your knees, pressing your arm away. Do one last butterfly arms. This time, really sinking deeper, arching that lower back, looking up, and then rounding out, dropping the head on the exhale. On the inhale, arch. On the exhale, round out, drop the head. Use your knees as leverage, drawing the shoulder blades together. Nice and strong movement here. Inhale, reset to center. Come up into camel pose. So now that our back is nice and warmed up, we're reaching back towards the heels. Again, if you'd like a block, let me know. I'll grab you one from the bag. We're reaching for the heels here, rolling the shoulders back, opening the chest, arching the lower back. Nice deep breaths. Two more breaths here. And sink out of that. We're going to come up again and do little lightning bolt, which is reaching behind your knees as your back arches a little bit. So we're going to breathe into it. We're reaching behind the knees here for little lightning bolt. So slowly come into the position. Arch, roll the shoulder blades, and then start walking your hands closer and closer. Breathing. Great. Well done, you two. Come into child's pose from this position. Round out the back. Opposite of what you've just done. Lowering the head to the mat or putting a block underneath it. On the inhale, draw yourself up to table. We'll do 10 cat-cow sequences. So hands are nice and wide, right underneath the shoulders. Knees are under your hips. On the inhale, you're arching, looking up. Drawing those hands towards your knees, almost like you're pressing the tiles away. Exhale, round out, looking back towards your feet. Inhale, arch up. Exhale, round out. Nice and purposeful motion here. Three more. Last one. Nice and slow. Back to neutral here. We're lifting the right arm and the left leg off the ground, parallel to the floor in our bird dog. Alternate sides. And alternate back and forth, left to right. Four more on each side. Last one on each side. Curling the toes underneath once you're finished. On the exhale, push up into down dog. And likely being your first one of the day, just ease into it. Swaying your hips left to right, pedaling the feet, that helps you break into it. Drawing the energy from the breath you take, moving it through the body. Those heels into the mat. From here, this is the most taxing on the shoulders that we'll do today. We're going to do a groiner and then a leg extension 10 times on each side. So starting with the right, coming into a plank, drawing that knee to the elbow, on the toe, extending the heart. Inhale to plank. Forward facing. Exhale, extend. Do as many as you can. Each time, pressing that heel a little bit farther into the mat. Last one. Come on down. We're sideways on our mat, up on the knees, widening them, and we're sinking forward into our frog as far as you can. So this is going to help you open that W. Forward and back. That's it. Off the knee, rocking forward and back. If you feel that just holding it in a certain position helps, then do that instead. Trying to lower your head down to the mat. Yourselves up. Draw those knees back together. And we're doing our groiner to leg extension on the other side. So come back up into down dog. On the exhale, curl those toes in. Press up. And on the inhale, come to plank. Left knee comes to left elbow. Exhale, extend that foot up. Inhale the plank, facing forward. Exhale, extend. Let your breath power your motion. Lowering down into child's pose here with a wider leg, resting the wrists. You can pull the arms over your back, interlace, roll the shoulders back, and extend those arms over the body. Lowering your arms, bringing them under your shoulders, and pressing up. Drawing those knees back together, we're coming back up into our down dog. And we're going to step through with the left foot this time into a high crescent moon lunge. Right. Yes, take some water. So y'all see my last Thursday, we did flat foot to standing in a chair. Today, we're going to curl the toes under, and we're literally just going to do the same thing, but this time it's a little bit different because you're not completely flat. So let me show you that again because that didn't feel any bit normal. So swinging up into chair, back down, swinging up into chair. So your toes are always curled under. So you're going to get a little bit of toe work as well, breaking up some of the fascia in the back of the feet and the front of the feet. So, inhale, come on up, chair. Come on back down. It's all right. You'll get it. Three more. Last one, come up and stay up. Bringing the arms all the way up overhead on the inhale. Hands into heart prayer. Now we're going to do a series of chairs followed by a prayer rotation. On the inhale, sink down, swing the arms up. Exhale, fold. Parallel to the floor, arms come back. Inhale up. Exhale, swinging all the way around. Back into prayer hands. Repeat this. Inhale up. Exhale, arms swing back. Inhale up. Exhale all the way around. Keep this going. Stop to catch your breath at any time you might need. Hands to heart and rotating your prayer pose, pressing that elbow away from the knee, against the knee. Open up the chest, nice and tall upper body, looking past the elbow to the ceiling. Opening up the arms towards the ceiling and to the floor, trying to make a nice straight line. The elbow against the knee, helping the rotation sink deeper, and come back to prayer. On your next inhale up, exhale all the way back around, reset here. Enjoy that breeze coming in. One full chair rotation followed by a second. We'll rotate to the other side. Inhale up. Exhale, swing back. Parallel to the floor. Inhale up. Exhale all the way around. And another half. Hands to prayer. Rotate over the opposite knee. pressing the elbow against the knee. Nice tall upper body, looking up to the ceiling past the elbow. And extend the arms up and down, trying to create a straight line, sinking into that rotation more, pressing the elbow against the knee. Nice deep breath. And release back to prayer. Inhale, swing the arms up. Exhale all the way around. Reset, catch your breath. And then pivot into a crescent lunge. So high lunge. You need water in between, please do so. So we're going to work on the hips and the hamstrings here. Crescent lunge, your back foot is up on the toes, your pelvis is forward facing, sinking down, swinging the arms up. Inhale, raising that chest up, exhale, sink a little bit farther, tilting the pelvis forward. Into warrior three here, raising that back foot off the ground, arms and leg are parallel to the floor. And lowering your front body, hands are to floor, you're doing a standing split here. Into warrior two, planting that back foot perpendicular. Arms are parallel to the floor, looking over that front extended hand. From here, shrink that stance halfway, falling into a forward bend, deep hamstring stretch, reaching for the floor. If you need your blocks, use them now and lower them as you're able to, as the hip hamstrings open up. Drawing your head to your knee.